I'm going to show you how to create a wavy text effect in Photoshop, and I'll show you how to easily animate that text. First, I created a new document. It's a 1920 by 1080. You can create a document any size you want for this. And now I'm going to fill the document with the foreground color, which is a gray. You can use any color. I just wanted it to be different from my background. I'll go over here to the toolbar, and I'll click on the horizontal type tool, and I'll type the word wave. I'm using the impact font, regular, and I'm going to make this bigger just so we have a better visual of this. Hit my check mark. Now I'm going to say Command T for the transform tool, right click and say warp, and up here at the top of the menu bar where it says warp, I'm going to drop this down and click on wave. And right now you have access to the square right here, and you can move it up and down to make a different wavy looking type text. All I need to do is commit this. I come up to window and click on character and get the character dialog, and you can change things about the font. Like right here, you can make space between the font bigger. You have all these controls right here to change the way this looks. And there is our wavy text effect. Now let's animate it. First, before we animate, make sure that any of the layers that we're using for animation are not smart objects. In other words, if they were, they need to be rasterized layers. If this layer was a smart object, you would just right click and say rasterize. First, we're going to come up to window and click on timeline. We want to create a video timeline, so I'll click on that. In our top layer over here on the timeline, I'm going to twirl this down, and these are all the different attributes or properties of this wave layer that we can animate. We're going to animate text warp. I'll click on this stopwatch right here, and it's going to enable a keyframe right there. You see it's yellow right on the playhead. I'm going to hit Command T, right click, and say warp. And up here, make sure it says warp and wave. So I'm going to move this up, something like that, and I'll click my check mark. I'm going to grab the end of the timeline and bring it to something like 3 seconds. I'm going to move my playhead over, somewhere in the middle. I'm going to say Command T, right click, and warp, making sure that it says warp and wave up here at the top. And I'm going to drag this down the other way and see it created another keyframe. So far we have 2 keyframes. I'm going to click the check mark. So we've got the wave going up and now down, and we want it to go back to the starting position. So this is going to be like a loop. So now I'm going to bring my playhead over to the end. I'm going to click this diamond over here to add a keyframe right at that position. And I'm going to copy what's in this keyframe right here. That's the starting position. And I'm going to click on the last keyframe and paste. There's a gear right here that has settings. I'm making sure that loop playback is checked. And if I hit the play button, this is what it looks like. So we've animated our wavy text effect. And by clicking on any of these keyframes and then moving them closer to each other or farther away will make your wave go faster or slower depending on the distance between the keyframes. And when you're done, you can come up to File, Export, Save for Web Legacy. So this is going to allow you to make a looping GIF or GIF, however you want to pronounce it. GIF 128, make sure your format is GIF. Make sure your looping options save forever. You can preview it right here, play the animation, you can save it, and then you can play it. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something new. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tutorials on Photoshop. Remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.